of the bacteria. Okay, and what does the capsule does? Okay, capsule could also be called as the, okay, let me write it here, glycocalyx or the capsule. Capsule, what does it do? It provides protection. Okay, if it is strongly attached with that of the bacteria, for example, a girl is wearing a very slim suit, so we can say it's its capsule or the glycocalyx. Okay, and if she is wearing a frock and you know the open type structure, we can say that she is wearing a slime wall. Okay, like slimy capsule or the slime layer. So this is the same fact of two different things. If it is firmly attached, we can say this is the capsule, and if it is loosely attached, we can say that it is the slime. So what does the capsule do to that of the bacteria? It provides the antibiotic protection. You know, for example, just think for a while that this is a bacteria. Okay, and this is the intact capsule. But this capsule provides the protection against the antibodies present inside our body. If any kind of antibody comes here, what happens to this is that it will reflect that and it will not let this antibody enter into that of the bacteria, so that it could not kill the bacteria. So this is how the bacteria protects itself from that of our defense. You know, immunogenic defense, which our body does naturally to our body. Like naturally when the bacteria comes and our body starts producing some kinds of defense. First line defense, second line defense, and antibodies and stuff like that. We have already studied in the immunology. But how it happens that bacteria comes inside, but still we get the infection, we get infected to that of some disease or something like that. We still get the disease. How it happens? It's due to the reason that antibodies are formed. Our body is perfectly normal. But what happens is, bacteria has got some kind of the capsule or the capsid, we can say, and it will protect and will forbid that antibody to enter inside that of the bacteria.
So this is
bacteria.
How bacteria get resistance against?
Yes, to one point we can say that it is. Others are plasmids and others to like penicillin and the cephalosporins and other different drugs that we are taking. And we are taking, the bacteria gets, you know, that we have got the copies of inside its brain. Bacteria, of course, doesn't have got the brain, but just like the humans, if we go somewhere, we get the copy, we get the memories of it, that okay, this was the thing. So bacteria also gets sensitive to that thing, to that drug. So if we give the same drug again and again, you can say that it will not work. So we will discuss each and every steps like later on. Here, which I want you people to remember is that antibodies, like capsules, forbid it to enter into that of the bacteria. And another thing which the bacteria does is, this capsule, it will let the phagocytosis not happen. It's anti-phagocytotic. For example, this was becoming, there was a macrophage and it was just getting stuck into that of the capsid. What it happens is when this macrophage or the, you know, dendritic cell or any kind of cell that would phagocytose, what it happens is when it comes near to it, it will move back or move ahead. Like here comes the macrophage and I will move step backward. This will be the same mechanism as with that of the bacteria. What happens is there are the receptors for this C3, okay, there are the receptors for C3B here on that of on the surface of the bacteria. All over it is present.
On bacteria?
On bacteria.
Capsule.
No, on that of the bacteria, inside that of the bacteria. Okay, but this capsule, what it does is it will not let this happen, cause it will reflect it back and it will protect the bacteria from phagocytosis. Okay. So this is the receptor for C3B, but there are also, you know, the signaling sections on that of the C3B on that of bacteria. But the capsule looks like that it is a resistance of bacteria, so that it could prevent bacteria from that of phagocytosis. So we can say that this, the capsule, is the gelatinous material, gelatinous layer which protect the layer of peptidoglycan. That's why they stay in that of different colors. They stay in that of different grams over there. Okay? So we are going to discuss the very basics of cell wall. So cell wall is the outermost structure or
outermost.
Okay. But inside that of the capsule, remember that. Don't confuse the two things together, okay? So here we have got one thing. This is one structure. And here we have got an other structure. Okay? This is, let's suppose that we have got the gram positive, and here we have got the gram negative bacteria. So what is the main difference between gram positive bacteria and the gram negative bacteria? The thing which we have to remember is that the gram positive bacteria have got a thickened layer of peptidoglycan. Peptidoglycan means that glycan means sugar. Okay, you people have to remember it, or I must say you people already knew that glycans means the sugars. Okay, so there are peptide linkages over here by the sugars.
Lam and lam.
Yes, we will discuss these things. So these are the peptide link. Oh, how many peptide linkages they have? How many peptidoglycans they have?
I think two.
Two peptidoglycans? What about you?
No.
How many peptidoglycans are there in one bacteria? There is only one peptidoglycan, one big macromolecule of peptidoglycan inside that of one bacteria. Okay? So, about the gram negative bacteria, you must know that there is peptidoglycan. Okay, but the peptidoglycan inside that of the gram negative bacteria is very thin as compared to this much big gram positive bacteria. Okay, this was the thing which I wanted you people to remember. So first there is the gram positive bacteria and the gram negative bacteria. These can stain, these cannot stain. Okay, this is the very basic thing which I wanted to know, wanted you people to know. Firstly, how the bacteria gets the energy. Let me ask a question to you, that how this bacteria gets the energy. They didn't have got the mitochondria, so how do they get the energy?
They are protein particles.
They have protein particles on
cell wall. Inside that.
Inside the cell membrane, they have got some protein particles which provide them the energy. Or we can say they have got the cytoplasmic membrane, they have got the energy production proteins. Okay?
Okay.
Afterwards, we are going to think about that what is cell wall responsible of. Cell wall is responsible to provide the rigidity, to provide the structure, to prevent it from the osmotic lysis, to prevent it from different harms that is from the environment, to protect it from like strange weird heat, or we can say it can protect it from resistance and stuff like that. So how it does it? There are some spore forming even bacteria. We will discuss on later. But here you have to remember about the peptidoglycans which are present inside that of the gram positive bacteria and the gram negative bacteria. This is a peptidoglycan layer. Okay? Peptidoglycan layer, here is this present. But what about the plasma membrane? Plasma membrane would be present over here. Okay?
Inside of that cell wall.
inside that.
जिस दर्द से कोई मक्तल में गया वो जान सलामत रखती है, ये आन तो जानी जानी है, इस जान की तो कोई बात नहीं.
So, what we were talking about the gram-positive bacteria and the gram-negative bacteria. I've already talked about that this is the gram-positive and this is the gram-negative. Gram-negative had got very thin layer of peptidoglycan and gram-positive have got a thick layer of that of the peptidoglycan. And the question remains over there, still it is like what is the difference between the peptide, what is the difference between the plasma lemma or the plasma membrane or the cell membrane of that of bacteria and the normal human being? Just tell me about the one difference and I will award you $100. It's the matter of fact that you people must have. Don't look on your books, on your textbooks. Just guess it. Guess for $100. No? Any guesses?
Phospholipids are more
in
humans?
In humans. Okay, no. It's not the thing. Oh, okay, I will offer $200 if you, not you answer, I will offer $200 if you answer this question. Okay, I will not create the suspense, rather I will take my $200 to my pocket. Okay, the difference between the bacterial phospholipids, don't tell me that you knew already. Let me tell you now. The deal is cancelled now. Otherwise, if I will go out of the class,
you will see the difference.
Yes.
Question?
What is the difference between the plasma lemma or the cell membrane of that of our cell and that of bacteria? No such differences? Okay. Well, now you have to give me $300. Let it be. The deal is over. Now I'm going to tell you. The difference between the bacterial plasma lemma and our cell wall is that in our cell wall, we have got the cholesterol molecules. We have got the sterols on that of our plasma membrane. But in case of that of bacteria, we don't have got any kind of cholesterol. No cholesterol on that of bacteria. This was so simple and you people lost the $200. So sad. And now here is another question. What is the difference between the bacterial cell membrane and that of the fungal cell membrane? And now I repeat my offer, there is $100. You have to tell me the exact difference. Rather, you are... Okay, let me tell you. I have to save my $100. So, the difference between the fungal and the bacterial and our cell is that fungi have got the ergosterols. We don't have got ergosterols. We have got just the sterols like cholesterol. So, ergosterols are... We have the drugs, like antifungal drugs that acts on this ergosterol. Okay, now this was the thing. So this is the phospho, like plasma membrane, there are lipid bilayer, that this is the same lipid bilayer that we have got, but the difference was about just the cholesterol or the sterols. So this was about that. Now, let me tell you one thing, that there are present some kind of tichioic acids, okay, on that of bacteria. On which kind of bacteria? On this.
Gram-positive
bacteria. Exactly. We have got the tichioic acid and we have got the tichioic molecules on that of our bacteria. We can say that these are our bacteria. okay, lipotic uric acid or the, and afterwards we have got antigen O. This core is made up of 5 different sugars. This antigen O is made up of 25 polymers over there. Okay, so this is the difference, and this is present all over the surface of that of the negative gram negative bacteria. We can say this is the endotoxin. Why this is called as the endotoxin? Because it is a toxic material. This is the endotoxin. So what we can say, this is so much toxic that in the intensive care unit or in any patient, that it can kill the patient. If there is gram-negative bacteria and we could not stop them, this will release endotoxin and endotoxin is formed, and this is the dangerous condition for that of the patient. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
So what, how does we know that this was about the endotoxin? We say this is endotoxin, this is core, this is the stuff like that, and everything has been happening over there. What does the lipid A has got the difference in different bacteria? Lipid A is same, core is same. What is the difference is the polysaccharide, only the polysaccharide. Now what we are discussing, we are saying that endotoxin or the lipopolysaccharide or LPS, we can say it LPS, lipopolysaccharide or the endotoxin. So they have got the lipopolysaccharide, gram negative, gram positive doesn't have got the lipopolysaccharide. It has got the endotoxin, it doesn't have that of the endotoxin. And due to the endotoxin, the patient may undergo shock. Okay, this is the condition of that of gram negative and gram positive bacteria. Okay, are you getting my point? What does happens to it is that we are saying that different doctors would say that penicillin would kill this bacteria, but penicillin could not kill this bacteria. Why is that so?
Because they have endotoxins.
Yes, they have got the endotoxin. Thank God I didn't offer any money, because if I would offer any money, I could lose that. So they have got the endotoxins, they don't have got the endotoxin. So penicillin is a big molecule. Everything which has to pass into that of this bacteria, it has to go through porins. But in this, they don't have got the lipopolysaccharide, they don't have got the endotoxin. So anything can go directly inside. There is a protective covering, which is a very protective covering, which kills that, which protects the bacteria from that of different damages. So the only way to get inside is porins. So penicillin is a big molecule. Penicillin is a big molecule. So how penicillin or cephalosporin or we have got different other things like aminoglycosides. We have got the tetracyclines. We have got
amoxicillins.
Yes, we have got metronidazole. Okay, there are so many drugs that we have got, the antibacterial drugs. So what is the difference between them and how they affect that? So penicillin is a very big molecule. It cannot cross to it, but it can kill this bacteria. So gram positive bacteria protects itself by beta lactams protects the gram-positive bacteria from penicillin, but endotoxins protect bacteria from penicillin. Okay, now how does the pharmaceutical companies just got to know that we have to kill this bacteria? They decreased the size of penicillin. Okay,
so
they decreased the size of
so that it can pass through.
So amoxicillin, they got amoxicillin, they got the anti pseudomonal drugs, which we say that terosiline, they have got the mesosiline, they have got the metronidazole. So these are the drugs which they discovered that they have got the small chunks, and they described it that they can go through the porins and then they can destroy that. Okay,
so how gram positive defense itself
is due to the beta lactams. They don't have got the beta lactams.
I just lost my one.
Okay. Now we are going to discuss about what? About the peptidoglycans. Okay. And peptidoglycans, how they are formed. Okay. First of all, what we are going to find is about how peptidoglycans are formed. And what are the drugs which act on them? What are the medicines which we will get when we get some kind of bacteria? What are the antibacterial drugs that we will take and then we will get cured? So first of all, how peptidoglycans are formed? By the cross-linking. You all must be knowing that this peptidoglycan is formed by what things? First of all, you must have to know that we have a certain NAM and also NAG. NAM and NAG molecule. Okay, what is NAM? NAM is N-acetylmuramic acid and N-acetylglutamic acid. N-acetylmuramic acid. Okay, so this is the thing. For example, we have got certain kind of bacteria which are present over there. Let's suppose that this is the bacteria. This is the gram-positive bacteria. In it, we have got NAM and we have got NAG. These are two different things present at different areas in that of bacteria. Then we will get to know that there is something on the surface of the bacteria, like on the cell membrane of the bacteria, which we can say there is bacteroferon. Bacteroferon is just like a transporter, which we were studying in intracellular signaling, that there are ATPases, there are, you know, channels and the stuff like that. So these are the transporters. They will do what? They will carry this and they will carry this. This is just like the lady in the Asian houses, just like which goes to the groom's house and the bride house and say, okay, come nearer and make the, you know, relationships and act just like the bonding agent, just like the glue, and say that, okay, now. And she also gets the commission and stuff like that. Asian people must know about that. So this is just like that aunt which goes to the groom's house, which goes to the bride house and say, okay, this is the groom, this is the guy, and stuff like that. So it goes to both houses and then it makes a bond and relation over there. Okay, after that, what happens is, after making a bond between them, what happens is the NAM and NAG will be get connected over there. Okay,
what's that aunt's name?
Bacteroferon. Okay, afterwards what happens is it will turn in a way and it will go outside. Okay, it will send, you know, after marriage couples go outside, out of the country. So they also go out of the country, out of the cell. So what it does is, when they go out, they make this peptidoglycan. So actually what this black layer is, this is NAM, here is NAG, here is NAM, here is NAG, here is NAM, here is NAG. So this is the, these are the couples. This aunt makes that, bacteroprenol phosphate, we can say. Well, let me write it, otherwise you will get confused. Bacteroprenol phosphate And this is done by vancomycin. Okay, vancomycin by the drug. But naturally in our body, there is also some kind of lysozymes which will not act, which will act as the debossing agent between the NAM and NAC, and they are called what? They are called lysozymes. They are naturally present in our body. Naturally, natural vancomycin in our body is lysozyme. Okay? Okay, lysozymes are present in?
Inside cell. Naturally?
No, it is present in our
lysosomes,
tears, saliva, mucus, vaginal secretions, and the stuff like that. Okay?
Lysozymes.
So these are the natural defenses against that of the bacteria. That's why when there, you know, there is not so common infection in our eyes, like if there is bacteria, because there are thousands, billions of bacteria in every day we get in touch to. Okay? So how don't we get the any kind of infection due to the exposed bacteria? This is due to the lysozyme, which will not, there would be bacteria, but it would not let the NAM and NAC to remain closer together. And then what happens is, if there is no NAM and NAC bonding, there will be no peptidoglycan. If there is no peptidoglycan, then you already know about the things that there will be no peptidoglycan, and our body will defense against it. Okay, so we have got the cyclosporine, bacitracin, vancomycin, penicillin and cephalosporin. Penicillin and cephalosporin works in the same manner. And you people must know that the classes and the subclasses I will teach you in the lecture of the penicillin and the antibacterial drugs, and afterwards I will teach the antifungal drugs and the, and stuff like that. But how would we are going to describe this is that tetramer is formed by transpeptidases, which is captured by penicillin, and here is the cycloserine, which will not let the alanine provoke over there, and then this is bisitrazine, which will not act this aren't to take the NAM and NAC outside, and there is also vancomycin, which will make a divorce, or it will not make a bond between the NAM and NAC, and this will cause the disruption of the peptidoglycan. And if the peptidoglycan gets disrupted, then you people must know that there will be no survival of bacteria. Okay. So this is the thing which I wanted to.
But we learned that the bacteria are mostly present in our mouth and in the vagina. Then how?
Yes,
they
it
are
is.
Present there if they can.
Okay, this is the question. This is a good question of that. There are thousands of bacteria, but we are not getting affected because of the lysozymes that we already have in our saliva, that we already have in our tears. You know, there will be bacteria, but it will not let the bacteria to grow further. And if we, you know, if it is like you take some kind of drugs or some medicines, so it will go out and it will be destroyed because it doesn't have peptidoglycans or the proper cell wall. Clear or confused? A little? Okay. Here we are saying that in our mouth there are thousands of bacteria, in vagina there are thousands of bacteria, and there are so many bacteria all over around the body. But you know, when there is a disease, there is a cure. If the bacteria goes inside our body, then there would be antibodies formed by it. Then there, if it is naturally cured, then we don't have to know about it. There are thousands of bacteria which go in every day inside our body that we don't know. But still we are alive and we don't have to take drugs sometimes. Not every day you take drugs. So it's due to the reason that in our body there are defenses that will not allow the bacteria to grow further. It will by itself, without knowing us, without letting to know us, it will destroy that bacteria. due to the lysozymes, due to the, you know, destructive enzyme, due to the antibodies, and due to the first line of defense, second amino glycosides. We would be having tetracycline.
For 50 years and 30 years, we have different.
Yes, we have
drugs.
Got the different drugs. Then we have got the tercycline. These are the three drugs which are present over there. We have got the quinolone, metronidazole, clofazepine, then rifampin, then rifabutin, then clindamycin, then erythromycin, then telithromycin, and then we have got the aminoglycosides, we have got the tetracyclines, we have got the tercyclines over there. Okay, now afterwards we are saying that there would be the anti-metabolites. Okay, that will stop the metabolism. Anti-metabolites are sulfonamides. There would be para-amino glycosalicylic acid. There would be trimethoprim.
The last one in 50s.
This clindamycin, erythromycin, and telithromycin. Okay. Then there would be sulfonamides. Then there will be para-amino salicylic acid. Then there would be trimethoprim, and what they does is they also have got the dapsone. These are the drugs present over there. Okay, and what about the cell wall synthesis? And if you don't know about the cell wall synthesis, then it must be a worry of fact. Cell wall synthesis. Just tell me that we have just studied about that. Penicillin. Ethamoxid. There would be isoniazid. There would be vancomycin. There would be clindamycin. There would be
cycloserine.
So these are the drugs which are already present over there. There will be polymycin also. All the mycines.
And bacitracine.
Bacitracine. We have got the so many drugs to inhibit the cell wall synthesis. We have got so many drugs. Like these are the whole class, whole family of the drugs which we can say that they are present over there, which will not allow the bacteria to make RNA, which will not allow the bacteria to make the DNA, which will not allow the bacteria to make the cell wall, which will not allow the bacteria for the protein synthesis, which will not allow the bacteria to metabolize, to do the normal functions. So these are the drugs which are present over there in a sense to just stop the bacterial further synthesis. Okay, it will not directly disrupt that of the bacteria. It will indirectly let the bacteria to kill itself. It will kill the bacteria indirectly, not directly.
So these all work on.
But these all work on the cell wall. Yes, the drugs which I told you lately. Okay, you get it? You have any questions about the cell wall, about the cell wall synthesis, about the cell wall's normal function, and about the pharmacology of it, or about anything regarding to this bacterial cell wall?
Vancomycin break down the nerve and nerve bones.
Yes.
So how they?
If the NAM and NAG bonds are not there, okay, you are asking about this. If the NAM and NAG bonds are not there, then what would be the cause of the peptidoglycan or the cell wall is not formed? It is disrupted. When it is disrupted, it is not formed, then the drugs or anything can come and kill the bacteria. Or even not the bacteria, only we can say that if the water, simple water comes inside, water and water comes inside, it will go to lysis, but it will burst itself. Okay?
Okay.
Any questions?
No.
Done?
Yeah.